To set up the universal pinion depth gauge set, you start with this shaft. Take the dial indicator, place it through the hole so the flat side is up. Temporarily take the Allen wrench and tighten it so it won't move. This is the long plug for General Motors. I have three different sizes, and this tip screws on to the end of the dial indicator. This is a calibrated hole. As we set this down in here, it will gently rest. And our goal here is to zero the dial indicator to this plug depth. Let's go ahead and turn it so we can see it. We hold the plug down and we gently bring this up about 10 or 15 thousandths of an inch so that this is straight down. And we just go ahead and tighten our Allen. So we should be very close to the 6 o'clock. At this point, we are also looking at the center small scale. We want to make sure that that's very close to zero. And we simply take and we want to zero this one as well. We have just calibrated this. When this is at zero, this dial indicator will be measuring 3 inches and 375 thousandths of an inch. This kit comes with two other sizes. This one will calibrate the dial indicator to 2.5 inches, and this one will be 1 inch and 900 thousandths of an inch. To properly use the pinion depth gauge, one, you have to have the pinion inserted and properly tightened into place with the bearings and spacers or the shims in place. You need to have the head very clean so that there's no dirt or marring. We have a special magnetic spacer that is designed to sit on the head of the pinion, and that'll be our measuring surface. We want to have it as much on the head of the pinion as possible, avoiding overhang as much as possible. We will locate the right size saddle spacers. These would fit in the saddle where the bearings ride. Some models have a particular reason to have one side cut out. And we would have one for each side. Before putting these in and tightening these down, you would want to put a little bit of motor oil. These are aluminum and they're going to gall or scar up very easily. So we want to lightly oil these. It's also very important that this surface right here, the saddles for the bearings, are also clean. There's no dirt or anything in those. Once you have both saddles lightly lubricated, place the spacers on the shaft. And set the shaft in place. You must be very careful with the dial indicator so that the tip does not jam while doing this setup. Take your bearing caps, again making sure they're clean, and put those in place. And torque these down to 25 foot-pounds. Your shaft should still rotate At this point, we can now make our pinion depth measurement. Take your dial indicator and rotate it up. And when you get near the bottom where it's going to hit the support, you must make sure to raise the plunger so it doesn't hit, and then you gently rest it on the magnetic support. We will be moving it back and forth on the magnetic support until we get our highest reading. We will subtract that from our original calibrated reading of 3 inches and 375 thousandths of an inch. When the gauge is rocked back and forth, when the plunger is at its highest point, it will move farthest to the right of the positive reading. As I get off center, it decreases. As I go past center, it decreases. So this value here of 10 thousandths of an inch, we must also focus in on the center small scale, which will tell us how many revolutions to add to that 10 thousandths of an inch. So a little closer. Small scale is on the 6, so it has gone 610 thousandths of an inch. Take our original value of 3 inches and 375 thousandths of an inch and minus the reading of 610 thousandths of an inch. The value left over is your pinion depth, which is 2 inches, 765 thousandths of an inch. Compare that to your specifications and add or subtract pinion depth shims to correct for pinion depth if it's not the proper value.
This animation represents our measured value of 2 inches and 765 thousandths of an inch. If the specification value is 2 inches and 785 thousandths of an inch, the pinion must move away from the ring gear center line in order to increase the measured value to the specified value. The shim will have to decrease in size by 20 thousandths of an inch. If the specification value is 2 inches and 745 thousandths of an inch, the pinion must move closer to the ring gear center line in order to decrease the measured value to the specified value. The shim will have to increase in size by 20 thousandths of an inch.